In this illustration, we intend to simulate the earthquake of concrete dam and water reservoir, as well as the foundation in the Abaqus software. Here, the infinite elements have been utilized in order to propagate the waves out of the foundation and for non-reflecting of them. Click on Create part. My first intention is to create geometric shape of water reservoir. I'll select the modeling space as two-dimensional of deformable shell types and enter the rough size of the tracing page as 2000, then click on Continue. Then I will draw a rectangle from the general density menu. The density of water will be equal to 1000 kilogram per cubic meter. I'll then select acoustic medium from the other menu, and here bulk module for the water is equal to 2.07 multiplied by 10 to the power of 9 Pascal, and finally click on OK. Click on Create Instance. Select the foundation and water reservoir. Here I'll click on Independent and Own OK. Then I'll click on Translate Instance. Select the foundation. First I'll select this point and then this one, and done. Then I'll draw a horizontal line in this manner and two vertical lines like this as well. After that, I'll select these lines and put the number of elements as 6 and OK. Finally, I'll click on Mesh Part Instance, select the whole of foundation and done. In this manner, the meshing is done. You should do your meshing in such a way that the nodes will overlap at a place where the dam contacts with the water reservoir. Also, you should do the meshing in such a way that the nodes will overlap where the dam contacts with the foundation. This has been well indicated in this picture, and the nodes have overlapped at a place where the dam is contacting. Actually intend to create a boundary condition for leading the compressive waves out of the acoustic space and non-reflecting of them into that place. To do so, I will click on Create Interaction. From here, I'll select the earthquake step, then click on Acoustic Impedance, continue and select the surface. Done. Here I'll select a non-reflecting option. I'll select planar here. We should use the option planar when the propagation waves are in form of plane waves. As you see, there are five figures in each line. The first figure indicates the number of elements, and the other four figures determine the nodes of that element. Well, here we intend to change the element number 14 into an infinite element. First, we find the element number 14. As you observe here, the pagination of nodes should be in such a way that first we have number 1, then number 36, then 35, and at the end 2. The first node should be number 1, second node number 36, the third node number 35, and the last node should be 2. You can also observe these elements which have changed into infinite elements. If I click on any of them, you will observe that it has 3 sides in this manner, indicating that they have been changed into infinite elements. Here I will click on plot contours, then on animate, here you can observe the tensile damage of the concrete. From here, I will select acoustic pressure. And then click on animate. As you observe, the compressive waves will exit from acoustic module and will be non-reflecting out there. From here, I will select stress contour.